Others, and we were denounced. And about 5-10 minutes' time, somebody came to tell us, go, take whatever you can take in your hands, take your sons, and leave the little one of 2.5, and that was me, because I was blonde, and they thought that nobody knew that I was Jewish, because I had a Jewish mom. That was the only bad thing why those children were killed, because they had a Jewish mom. And they told my parents, if you find a good hiding place, come and pick her up. Well, it took 3.5 years. I didn't see my parents. I didn't see my brothers. But I was very, very happy because these people had no children and they treated me like their own little girl. I had everything. And then I tell the children the story of my husband. And he wasn't that lucky. His parents are there where we go tomorrow. And they were Belgian citizens. And they were taken. There was one train going out from Dossin, from Mechelen, with 900 Belgian citizens, but they were also Jews. So they were taken to Auschwitz, and in the evening when they arrived, the big part of them didn't exist anymore because it had to go quickly, because they were Belgian, but nobody did anything for them. And my husband saw them go onto the truck, and that's the last picture he saw of his parents. His grandparents and his sister were also in hiding, and they had no luck on the end of the war, because the Americans came to help us, and they bombed. And the place where they were hidden, the grandparents and his daughter, his sister, and his aunt, was so much bombed that nobody survived. That was the end of the war. So he was 9 when he came back on his own to Antwerp, only with his grandparents from his mom, his mom's parents. So his story is very bad. But I give the two ones, because the 50% who were saved in Belgium, all those righteous, we honored them yesterday in Brussels in the Synagogue of Europe. And we are very proud, and we can never forget these people. We are not allowed to forget them. I was lucky because every weekend after my mom came and picked me up to go and live back with my own family, she promised that I would come back the weekends to my war parents, which I did all my life. But I had to bury 4 people, my own parents and my 2 war parents. But I had a full life, and I was very lucky to have met these people. Now, a part of that, in Antwerp, in Belgium, we used to have a security to feel secure to take our children to Jewish schools, to live a Jewish life, to go to synagogue whenever they want to go to. And since the 1st of September, they took away the army. No security anymore. The mayor does whatever he can do with the police, but it's far from the same. A lot of parents come to us and say, is it safe to take my child to a Jewish school? They scared. Why can Jewish people not live their Jewish life without fear? Fear. We are all the same. That's what I tell the students in school. What is the difference between you and me? I went to a school once and I hear the students say, "When is that Jewish lady coming?" And I was standing next to them. I said, "Which Jewish lady?" "Well, you know, with a false hair and black." I said, "Well, I'm that Jewish lady, but I'm not dressed like that. Not all of them are dressed like that. In Antwerp, you can see them in the street, and apparently it disturbs a lot of people, because we can hear them, youngsters, bad Jews, what are you doing here?" And it's becoming more and more. And I can't understand, because we are all the same. If you believe and you have faith, whatever faith you have, it should be in your heart, not on the street, and not educating your children that one faith is better than the other one. This is not acceptable. And that's what I'm doing nearly every day. And I'll do it as long as I can stand on my two feet. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Regina, for your very powerful testimony. And when you spoke about the importance of educating children and students, we will conclude this panel by listening to the message of Dr. Zoltan Maruza, who is the State Secretary for Ministry of Science and Education in Hungary, who is also a signatory of the very important document called the Guidelines for International Discourse on History and Memory. Please, the message of Dr. Zoltan Maruza. It's coming. Okay.
Dear Excellencies, Rabbis, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your kind invitation, and I honestly apologize that the worsening pandemic situation didn't allow me to take part in person in the conference organized by the European Jewish Association. However, I consider it really important that in this video message, in the Positive Changes and Solutions panel of the event, I relate how we continue or combat against anti-Semitism in education in Hungary. Hungary commits itself to the declaration of the Stockholm International Forum on the Holocaust, which promises, amongst others, to further promote Holocaust education, Holocaust remembrance, and Holocaust studies in schools, at universities, in communities, and in other institutions. The government of Hungary devotes a high priority to combating anti-Semitism. We declare zero tolerance for Holocaust denial and racism. Using administrative measures is important in the fight against anti-Semitism, but we can only achieve lasting results if we introduce pupils to the lives and customs of peoples of groups from different cultures living with us. Knowledge is the first step of acceptance. It was in 2012 that we introduced the new national core curriculum and the subject-based framework curricula based on it in Hungary. During the curricular content reform, we heeded to highlight the fact that Jewish history and the positive message of Hungarian Jewish coexistence appear in the content regulation, thus in the national core curriculum and in the subject-related framework curricula as well as in the textbooks based on them. To this end, as representatives of Jewish people in Hungary, we involved the Jewish Community Roundtable and the Action and Protection Foundation into the curricula and textbook preparation processes. During negotiations, we identified in the curricula and in the textbooks the important points of Jewish history and coexistence, highlighting which may be important to strengthen ethnical and cultural diversity. During the negotiations at that time, 6 parts of the core curriculum and 52 parts of the framework curricula were modified. This was when the concept of Hebrew Bible was introduced in the content regulations, the destruction of Jerusalem in the year 70 became a mandatory historical date, the role of the Jewish community in the events of the War of Independence in 1848-49, and the collective punishment imposed as a consequence were also included, while the representation of political and cultural life in the 20th century Hungary has become more sophisticated. The Holocaust was, of course, already discussed in previous curriculum versions. In teaching history and the related documents, the history of the Jewish and in the Carpathian Basin and the history of the Hungarian Jewish coexistence are priority topics for us. Holocaust, including the Shoah in Hungary, is obviously a priority topic in history teaching. Many Hungarian citizens were taken during the World War to Auschwitz, and only few of them could return home. The curriculum recommends visiting the Holocaust Memorial Center in Budapest to all secondary school students. In my opinion, the introduction of this period meets European standards. In relation to the present of Jews, the Hungarian curriculum framework deals with the establishment and development of the modern state of Israel, as well as the presentation of the modern history and current situation in the Middle East, so that young people understand the basis of the extremely complex situation there. Hungarian-Israeli relations in the field of in-service teacher training on the Holocaust have a history of more than 20 years and have been supported by both states. In addition to curricula, content development and teacher training, we also provide opportunities for students to be able to express their opinions in the framework of extracurricular activities. Therefore, the 16th of April has been designated as the Holocaust Remembrance Day, which is held in all high schools since 2001. On these days, schools decide to themselves how to remember the victims. They can take a thematic walk or visit the Holocaust Documentation and Education Center, for which the state provides free public transportation to all students. Or they can visit memorial sites, hold commemorations, film screenings, or presentation of research projects within the school. I believe that the measures introduced now serve our common deals in a complex way, so we want to continue our cooperation. You can still count on us. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you, dear panelists. Thank you for your strong words. And now I will leave the floor to my colleague, Ruth. Please. Thank you.
My name is Ruth Daskalopoulou Isaac. I have the pleasure of having two surnames, both a Greek one and a Jewish one. And I am the head of EU relations at the European Jewish Association. A lot of you might know me because I'm the one who is normally communicating to you. It was a pleasure to hear all the speeches we had so far. I have a wonderful panel here that they just joined me. But before we get to the panel, we're going to have first the honor and the privilege of hearing from His Excellency, President of the Parliamentary Assembly of Bosnia and Herzegovina, His Excellency, Mr. Dragan, if I pronounced it correctly. I cannot do it. Čović.
Yes, Čović.
Your Excellency, and his translator, if you can bring the microphone. Thank you.
Nikad više. Ovo je zakletva koju svjetski čelnici moraju položiti kako bi bili sigurni da holokaust nikada neće biti zaboravljen.
Never again. That is the oath that world leaders must take to make sure that Holocaust will never be forgotten.
Sudbina židovskog naroda tijekom Drugog svjetskog rata u Bosni i Hercegovini bila je užasna, kao što je bila i sudbina većine evropskih židova u zemljama pod utjecajem ili okupacijom nacističke Njemačke. Neposredno prije Drugog svjetskog rata na području NDH živjelo je gotovo 40.000 židova, od čega oko 25.000 živjelo je u današnjoj Hrvatskoj, a 15.000 u mojoj domovini Bosni i Hercegovini.
The destiny of the Jewish people during World War II in Bosnia and Herzegovina was a horrible one, as was the destiny of most European Jews in the countries under the influence of or occupied by Nazi Germany. Just before World War II, almost 40,000 Jews lived on the territory of independent state of the Croatia, out of which around 25,000 Jews in present-day Croatia and 50,000 in my homeland in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Ustaška vlada je 1941. godine donijela rasne zakonske dekrete kojima židovima na našim krajevima oduzela temeljna ljudska prava. Od 1941. do 1945. godine ustaški režim je vodio koncentracijske logore i logore smrti, od koje su najveći bili Jasenovac, a ostali poznati logori su Danica, Kerestinec, Lobogard, Lepoglava. Čak su i djeca do 14 godina bila zatvarana. Od 1941. do 1945. godine na području današnje Hrvatske i Bosne i Hercegovine ubijeno je više od 30.000 židova.
In 1941, the Ustaša government adopted racial law decrees, depriving Jews in our region of fundamental rights. From 1941 to 1945, the Ustaša regime operated concentration and death camps, the largest one being Jasenovac. Other well-known camps were Danica, Kerestinec, Lobogard, and Lepoglava. Even children under 14 were imprisoned. From 1941 to 1945, more than 30,000 Jews were murdered on the territories of modern-day Croatia and Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Tragične povijesne činjenice govore nam da je u svibnju 1943. godine uhićeno 1700 Židova iz Zagreba i 1300 iz okruženja i deportirano u Auschwitz-Birkenau. To je bilo njihovo konačno odredište.
Tragic historical facts show us that in May 1943, 1,700 Jews from Zagreb and 300 from the surroundings area were arrested and deported to Auschwitz-Birkenau. It was their final destination.
Ovo nisu samo brojke. To su ljudi koji su imali ime, obitelj, budućnost, život. Doprinosili su znanstvenom, kulturnom, gospodarskom i društvenom životu Hrvatske i Bosne i Hercegovine. No sudbina je htjela da postanu žrtve najukrutnijih događaja u povijesti čovječanstva, holokausta.
These are not just numbers. These are humans who had name, a family, a future, a life. They contributed to the scientific, cultural, economic and social life of Croatia and Bosnia and Herzegovina. But fate willed that they become victim of the cruelest event in the history of humanity, the Holocaust.
Židovski narod s naših prostora bio je ponosna zajednica u najhumanijem i najprogresivnijem smislu, koja je doprinijela napredovanju, suvremenosti, razvoja i prosperiteta u svim životnim sferama, u kojima su postavili najviše standarde učinka i izvrsnosti. Nikada nisu bili dužni društvu, ali su ga uvijek zaduživali kroz mukotrpno i predan rad, kroz visoko razvijenu društvenu kulturu i obrazovanje, sve to neophodno za izgradnju, njegovanje i održavanje stabilne i prosperitetne budućnosti za koje žudi naša krhka i ranjeno društvo.
The Jewish people from our region were a proud community in the most humanistic and progressive sense, contributing to the thrive of modernity, development and prosperity in all life spheres, in which they set the high standards of performance and excellence, never owing to the society, but always adapting one through arduous and dedicated work. Through highly developed social culture and education, all indispensable to build, foster and sustain a stable and prosperous future to which our fragile and wounded society is craving for.
Svoje duboko žaljenje i suosjećanje dugujemo onima koji su stradali, našim voljenim sunarodnjacima, prijateljima i susjedima. To je najmanje što možemo i moramo učiniti da spasimo sebe i svijet oko sebe od potencijalnog ponovnog budućih zala i ljudskih padova.
We owe our profound regrets and sympathies for those who perished, our beloved countrymen, friends and neighbors. This is the last we must do to save ourselves and the world around us from the potential abyss of future evils alike and human falls down.
Ništa ne može ispuniti prazninu. Zauvijek će nam nedostajati oni i njihovi potomci, također i u našoj Bosni i Hercegovini, u kojoj je židovski narod trpio patnje, teror i proterivanje. Holokaust je iza sebe ostavio slomljeno čovječanstvo, dotaknuši najdublje i najmračnije mjesto u povijesti čovječanstva. Za sobom je ostavio trajne posljedice s kojima se danas suočavamo.
Nothing can fill the void. We are going to miss them and their descendants forever, also in Bosnia and Herzegovina, in which Jewish people underwent suffering, terror and explosions. The Holocaust has left behind shattered humanity, touching down the deepest and darkest place in the history of mankind. It has also left behind lasting consequences we face to this day.
Okupljeni danas ovdje, u ovom tužnom trenutku, kada obilježavamo 83. godišnjicu Kristalne noći, s najdubljom tugom i pijetetom obilježavamo spomen, ali slavimo ustrajnost onih koji se danas sjećamo u obliku vječne ostavštine kao putokaz cijelom čovječanstvu i naraštajima koji dolaze. Holokaust je bio užasan ishod antisemitskog vala u Europi, vala znanja, vala zla, neznanja i mržnje. Naša odgovornost je bila osuditi i poduzeti sve mjere da to spriječimo i zaustavimo, ali nismo uspjeli. Stoga je odgovornost našeg društva razviti snažne mehanizme, spriječiti i braniti ljude koji su danas pogođeni antisemitizmom.
Gathered here today, in this grievous moment when we mark 83rd anniversary of Kristallnacht, the night of broken glass, November pogrom, we commemorate with deepest sorrow and compassion, but also celebrate perseverance of those we commemorate today in the form of everlasting legacy as a signpost for the entire humanity in generations to come. The Holocaust was an atrocious outcome of anti-Semitic wave in Europe, a wave of evil, ignorance and hate. Our responsibility was to condemn and take all measures to prevent and stop it, but unfortunately we failed. Thus, The responsibility of our society today is to develop strong mechanism to prevent anti-Semitism and defend people affected by it today.
Kao Hrvat Bosne i Hercegovine, danas svečano stojim ovdje na ovom mjestu stradanja u ime naroda Bosne i Hercegovine, ispričavam se i tražim oprost, odajući najdublje poštovanje milijunima koji su brutalno ubijeni u holokaustu, kao i onima koji su preživjeli, obvezujući se na pobunu protiv antisemitizma.
As a crowd of Bosnia-Herzegovina, I solemnly stand here today in this place of grave suffering on behalf of the peoples of Bosnia-Herzegovina, apologizing and asking for forgiveness, paying the deepest of respect to the millions who were brutally murdered in the Holocaust, as well as to those who survived, committing the revolt against antisemitism.
Hvala vam.
Thank you.
Thank you. Your Excellency, thank you for your speech. It was an honor for us to have the President of the Parliament with us. But also it is an honor, I want to introduce you to the panel. First, we have State Secretary of the Ministry of Science.